Round 2 of the Stanley Cup Playoffs continues Friday night with Game 4 between the Lightning and Bruins in Boston and a critical Game 5 in Las Vegas between the Sharks and the Golden Knights. We'll help you handicap this pair of games like a pro with our full betting preview. Tampa Bay Lightning at Boston Bruins, -156, Lightning lead series 2-1. The Tampa Bay Lightning may have produced their most complete performance of the season last time out and look to take a stranglehold of the Eastern Conference semifinal series when they visit the Boston Bruins for Game 4 on Friday night. Andre Palat scored twice in the first 3:19 of the contest and the Lightning limited the Bruins to 15 shots without a goal over the final two periods for a 4-1 victory Wednesday to take a 2-1 series lead. We have to expect that we're going to get their best game, Tampa Bay captain Steven Stamkos, who scored an empty net goal for his first of the series in Game 3, told reporters Thursday. They're a very good team for a reason. They've responded to these situations all year and we just have to elevate our game. Patrice Bergeron scored the only goal on the power play for Boston in the first period of Game 3, giving him 3 tallies in the series and 4 in the last 4 playoff games, but the Bruins struggled to get quality chances 5-on-5 for the second straight contest. The last two games, we didn't play enough of our game, Boston coach Bruce Cassidy told reporters. They've played their game better than we've played ours, and they've won both games. We were slow at times, and stubborn. Bruins right wing David Pastrnak, who was tied for the league lead with 19 points in the playoffs entering Thursday, has 6 assists in the series but registered only 1 shot on goal in the past 2 games. TV, 7 p.m. ET, NBC Sports Network, CBC, TVA series price per Westgate LVSUPERBOOK, line moves and betting action. The Bruins opened as -150 home favorites for Game 4 and as of Thursday night that money line has been steady. 56% of covers consensus wagers have come in on the favorite Bruins. The total hit betting boards at 6 and has yet to move. Check out the complete line history here. Injury report, Lightning, LW Adam Ern, questionable, lower body. Bruins, D. Brandon Carlo, out for season, ankle, LW Anders Bjork, out for season, shoulder. Goalie showdown, about the Lightning, 6-0-2-5-3-2-53-34-0, Palat recorded 2 points in each of the last 2 games, helping to occupy the puck along with line mates Tyler Johnson and Braden Point, and has been a consistent performer in his 54 playoff games, +6 rating, 37 points. He's a beast, coach John Cooper said of Palat. You probably get spoiled a little bit because I've watched that act before happening in playoff series in 2015 and 2016. Those guys that kind of go under the radar and don't get the credit they deserve but they never seek it and they don't care, that's what you have in Palat. Versatile forward Yanni Gourde registered an assist in Game 3 after returning to the team Wednesday after witnessing the birth of his first child. About the Bruins, 5-5-2-5-9-3-41-45-0, Cassidy is contemplating some lineup changes for Game 4 to add a spark as Boston has been outshot 104-73 in the series without much punch from the bottom two forward lines and rookie forward Ryan Donato could get a chance. We've got some guys that weren't dressed for Game 3 that have played well for this team, Cassidy told reporters. Quote, some guys, among the forwards, have had a tough time. If they stay in, obviously, they need to be better. Veteran left wing Rick Nash had an assist Wednesday and led the team with 6 shots on net, giving him 11 in the series, while rookie defenseman Charlie McAvoy logged a game-high 27.09 of ice time without a shot but recorded 5 hits. Matchup chart, trends, asterisk Lightning are 19-7 in their last 26 conference semifinals games. Asterisk Bruins are 22-7 in their last 29 home games. Asterisk over is the 2nd of April 11 in Lightning's last 17 road games. Asterisk under is the 2nd of April 15 in Bruins' last 21 versus a team with a winning percent above .600. Asterisk Lightning are 8-3-3-4 in the last 45 meetings in Boston. Got a complete list of hot and cold trends, here. San Jose Sharks at Vegas Golden Knights, -150, 5.5, series tied 2-2. While their Western Conference semifinal is tied at 2 games apiece, the San Jose Sharks have slowly been imposing their will on the Vegas Golden Knights since absorbing a 7-0 drubbing in the series opener. The Sharks posted a decisive 4-0 victory Wednesday and have won 2 of 3 as the best of 7 set shifts to Las Vegas for Game 5 on Friday night. San Jose coach Peter DeBoer lamented the fact that his team had been continually playing from behind and chasing the game the whole series, but the Sharks struck twice in the opening period of Game 4 and never looked back. "I know we're getting better every game," DeBoer said. "So I know we're going to get off the plane in Vegas and we're going to play a good game, and it's going to take a real good game to win in there. We're going to have to win a game in there in order to win the series." The Golden Knights lost for only the second time in 8 postseason games and were blanked for the first time since February 19, but they head back to Las Vegas with the series narrowed to a best of 3, and 2 of those, if necessary, to be held at raucous T-Mobile Arena. "Nobody thought it was going to be an easy series either," Vegas netminder Marc-Andre Fleury said. "We're in good shape 2-2, going home, and obviously it stinks to lose this one. Put it behind and get ready for the next one, TV, 10 p.m. ET, NBC Sports Network, CBC, TVAS series price per LVSUPERBOOK, line moves and betting action. Vegas opened as -150 home favorites for Game 5, and as of Thursday night that money line has been steady. 68% of covers consensus wagers have come in on the favorite Knights. The total hit betting boards at 5.5 and has yet to move. Check out the complete line history here. Injury report, Sharks, see Joe Thornton, questionable, knee. Golden Knights, D. Clayton Stoner, out indefinitely, abdominal. Goalie showdown, about the Sharks, 5-1-2-8-8-3-41-46-0, there had been speculation that veteran center Joe Thornton would play for the first time since January 23 due to the uncertain status of Jonas Donskoy, who returned from a one-game absence and supplied a back-breaking goal in the final seconds of the opening period. Fourth-line forward Marcus Sorensen, who registered only 5 goals in 32 regular season games, opened the scoring Wednesday and is tied for second on the team with 4 tallies in 8 playoff contests. "All 4 lines played really good," said Tomas Hertl, who netted his team-leading 5th goal of the postseason. "Everyone is scoring, not just one line," about the Golden Knights, 5-7-2-5-5-3-45-42-0, Vegas no. One line of William Karlsson, Jonathan Marchessault and Riley Smith was finally shut down in Game 4, combining for 11 shots on net after amassing 19 points through the first 3 meetings. Even though San Jose has pierced the Golden Knights for 11 goals in the last 3 games, the team has no concerns over the play of Fleury, who notched 3 shutouts in the first 5 games of the playoffs. "Amazing goalie, amazing person," defenseman Braden McNabb said. "We're very fortunate to have him. Maybe we rely on him too much, but he's our backbone, and we are 100% confident in him back there." Matchup chart, trends, asterisk, Sharks are 22-5 in their last 27 versus Pacific, asterisk, Golden Knights are 13-1 in their last 14 home games versus a team with a winning road record. Asterisk over is 7-1-3 in Sharks' last 11 conference semifinals games. Asterisk over is 13-1 in Golden Knights' last 14 Friday games. Check out a complete list of hot and cold trends, here.